So I'm a consultant dermatologist based in University Hospitals Birmingham and Skin Clinic. I have special interest in pigmentary disorders, and I started running hyperpigmentation service based in my NHS hospital for nearly 2 years. So hopefully today I can share my knowledge and experience in diagnosing and managing hyperpigmentation. I will start by looking at the importance of understanding hyperpigmentation with increasing skin of color population. We will then look at the skin anatomy, mechanism of melanogenesis, and Fitzpatrick skin type before moving on to etiology and differential diagnosis. Due to the limited time, I will briefly go through the management of common hyperpigmentary disorders. The main aim of this talk is not to educate you to manage all hyperpigmentary disorders, but to understand what can be managed in your clinic and what needs referral to dermatologists. So skin of color refers to non-white skin, which usually refers to Fitzpatrick skin type 4 to 6. There are trends around the world that skin of color population has been rising. And in the UK, the last census in 2011 have shown increase in non-white population from 8.7 to 14% over 10 years period, and higher prevalence up to 40% in London. And it has been estimated that nearly half of the US population will be skin of color by 2050. And therefore, a full understanding of skin condition affecting this group is very important. So many studies in the past have shown hyperpigmentation disorders are prevalent in skin of color. So the prevalence of melasma, which is one of the most common hyperpigmentary disorders, ranged between 1.5 to 33%. And several studies showed that the pigmentary disorders are one of the commonest causes of dermatology consultation in African American patients in the US outpatient setting. As there were lack of UK-based prevalence studies, our hyperpigmentation clinic carried out a prevalence study reviewing all general dermatology outpatients who attended between 2013 and 2018. And out of nearly 40,000 patients, 2.5% of the patients had PIH and only 0.25% had melasma, which is a lot lower than other prevalence studies done elsewhere in the world. This shows the nature of NHS referral, and many people are considering hyperpigmentation as a cosmetic problem rather than medical problem. This study also demonstrated that majority of these patients with hyperpigmentation concerns seek advice in private sectors in the UK. Therefore, you need to have a good education and manage these patients safely and effectively. So not all hyperpigmentary concerns, however, will be addressed by treatments offered in your clinic. And it is important to understand what is hyperpigmentation before you start treating these patients. Its definition is the darkening of an area of skin or nails caused by increased melanin. And hyperpigmentation is a description, but not a diagnosis. So you will need to. So we will start by looking at how melanin is produced and why its production is increased. To understand how melanin is produced in our skin. The outermost layer of our skin is epidermis, which is mainly comprised of keratinocytes and melanocytes, where melanin is produced. Below epidermis is dermis, where it is highly vascularized and contains collagen and elastin fibers, as well as many cells, including fibroblasts, T cells, macrophages, mast cells, and neutrophils. Melanin, which gives color to the skin, is a mixture of biopolymers produced by melanocytes, located in the basal layer of epidermis. Melanin is actually produced within melanosomes, which is a small organelle within melanocyte, which then travels along the dendrites, which are finger-like projections, to release melanin to nearby keratinocytes. And each melanocyte is connected to 30 to 40 keratinocytes via the dendrites.